Are you also confused between Dolce & Gabbana, the one, and La Nuit de L'Homme? Which one is the best date night fragrance? Let me help you out. Hey guys, and welcome to yet another video of Fragrance Jam, and today we are gonna talk about the most discussed topic in the fragrance community, which is the best date night scents. Now, if someone is speaking about date night fragrance, there are two perfumes that are discussed the most. Not referring to all the high-end niche fragrances, I'm referring to the designer stuff this time. I might make the niche stuff, the niche perfume videos later. Right now, I'm talking about these two fragrances, which are Dolce & Gabbana The One EDP and La Nuit de L'Homme. Now, these two fragrances are like the most hyped fragrances, the most talked about fragrances. If you search about this or this one, you'll be getting like a thousands of reviews on YouTube. So what makes these two perfumes that good? And if you don't have that much budget, and if you're looking for only one, which one should you buy? So first, we're gonna discuss about La Nuit de L'Homme, and let me spray this one before talking about it. Now, this is the best seller from YSL, and there's a reason behind it. When this came, this was the one of a kind thing, because the DNA that this has was not present in any of the perfume at that time. I'm not sure this came in 2008 or 9, correct me if I'm wrong, but this is the perfume. This is what it is. This is a history, and this perfume is reformulated a lot now. Earlier, this perfume used to come with dark juice, now it is light, and to me it is completely fine, because I am a heavy sprayer. I do not expect my perfumes to perform like 8 to 9 hours with just two sprays. It is brutal to expect something like this, no matter what people are saying. Even the 2020 batch or 2019 batch or 2018 batch works good for me. This one is a 2020 batch. I do not get any performance issues with this one. This is a cold weather scent, first of all, and indoor scent. You cannot expect it to perform when you are outside. So it is called date night scent for a reason, because you won't go on a date night during daytime, you know, date night. So don't expect it to perform good if you're wearing it in the daytime, because the temperature is different. It is an indoor scent, so expect it to perform good when you are indoors in an air-conditioned environment, or even in normal environment, but not out. So this is what this perfume is about. You'll be seeing the notes breakdown here on the screen. Let's talk about Dolce & Gabbana The One EDP now. The One EDP is actually flanker of Dolce & Gabbana The One. It was the same bottle, same construction. It's just the juice was light. Here the juice is dark, and I'm not sure about the juice color actually, but I think the gradient is on the bottle. The juice color is same. I haven't seen this juice in the bottle because I haven't decanted it that much, so I'm not sure, but the bottle is pretty good. Now, as compared to the original one, this one is very good, appealing in looks, bottle wise I'm saying. Spraying this perfume every time makes me smile. So I had this 50 ml bottle of this one. I liked it so much that I purchased 150 ml, the biggest bottle available in the market. Again, the criteria for this perfume is similar to what I discussed for La Nuit de L'Homme. This is an indoor scent. You cannot expect it to perform that much in outside atmosphere, but I'll tell you one thing, this performs better than La Nuit de L'Homme. So let's say if I'm doing 8 sprays of La Nuit de L'Homme and 8 sprays of this one, I'm pretty sure that this one is gonna perform more, and it's gonna reflect and project more. The reason is because this is EDP and that one is EDT. Of course, this is more concentrated. That is the reason it will perform better. Now, the main topic here, which one is the best? I'll be comparing these two perfumes with three scenarios: the price, the scent profile, and longevity. Now, if you're asking me about the price of this one, you'll be getting the 150 ml or let's say 100 ml bottle of this one for around 5,000 rupees or 6,000 rupees. Let's say 6,000. This perfume will be for 7,000 to 8,000 for 100 ml. The second thing is scent profile. These two are way different in scent profile. Some of the people also mentioned that these two are similar, you know, kind of similar, but I disagree. This perfume will give you a lot of cardamom. This perfume will give you other spices. Cardamom is still present here, but you know, not that prominent thing. So personally, what I like is this one, Dolce & Gabbana The One EDP. I love the scent profile of this one. This is pretty unique and this is more people friendly. And the third one is longevity. Which one performs better for longer duration? Again, The One EDP is winner. Though it be cold atmosphere, or let's say if you're outside or if you're inside, this is gonna perform better. And I've tested these two, so I know what I'm saying. So yes, the final answer, the final verdict is that if you are trying to get any one out of these two, I would personally recommend you to go with this one. This is way more better as compared to La Nuit de L'Homme. Not saying that La Nuit de L'Homme is not good. Let's say if you have this, or if you don't like this DNA, then you should definitely gonna go this one. So at the end of the day, choice is completely yours. What I'm saying is that if, for me personally, when I compare these two, I reach out for this one first. So this is it regarding today's video, guys. If you like this video, please share and subscribe, and I will see you in the next episode. Take care and have a great day.